When you live in the White House, you live pretty high. Sometimes I would have dinner alone, and I'll describe it to you. First, the head butler, Fields, a great big 200-pounder and a fine-looking man, a very fine person, would come in and say, very seriously, Mr. President, dinner is served. I'd walk into the dining room. Barnett, another of the butlers, was one of my servants, too. Barnett in tails and a tie would pull out my chair and push me up to the table. And he looked very, very, very much like the pictures you see of butlers in these high hat houses. Brings me a fruit cup. Barnett takes away the empty cup. Fields brings me a plate. Barnett brings me a tenderloin. Fields brings me an asparagus. Barnett brings me carrots and beets. I have to eat alone and in silence in a candle-lit room. And she don't believe I was getting service. You never saw any. I ring, and Barnett takes the plate away and the butter plates. And Fields comes in with a napkin and silver crumb tray. There are no crumbs, but Fields had to brush them off the table anyway. Barnett brings me a plate with a finger bowl and a doily on it. I remove the finger bowl and the doily, and John puts a glass saucer and a little bowl on a plate. Barnett brings me some chocolate custard. Fields brings me a demitasse. At home, that's a little cup of coffee with about 2 ups in it. And my dinner is over. I take a hand bath in a bowl and go back to work. And what a life that was.